Hi, I'm Maria Walther.
I'm Jessica Walsh.
And we're two traveling teachers. We're here at Gwendolyn Brooks School in September, and we're going to kick off book talks about the portrait of a graduate. So in Indian Prairie District 204, where we both are traveling teachers, we have adopted this portrait of a graduate just to think about the skills that we want our students to leave with when they graduate, so that whether we teach 7th grade or 1st grade kindergarten, we're all focusing on the same competencies. So we're going to zero in on citizenship today with our book talks, and
yeah.
Jessica's going to kick us off.
So right away, I thought about this new book from Pablo Cartaya, Each Tiny Spark. It's his third middle grade novel. And actually, I think this might be my favorite.
Oh.
I probably will say this about every new one that he writes, but I just love Amelia in this book. So the main character describes herself as, her mind wanders, she says. It's hard for her to stay focused in class. And so her social studies teacher assigns her and her class this project to research their community, which right away, like, my heart just leapt because I love doing projects like that as a social studies teacher and an ELA teacher dealing with writing and stories. But this is such a beautifully crafted and really well thought, like thoughtfully crafted middle grade, because it deals not only with her neurodiversity very sensitively, but also with themes of immigration, PTSD. Her father comes back from the military after a leave, and he kind of isolates himself in the garage working on an old car. And while her mother has been the foundation of their home, goes on a business trip, she's left with her abuela and her father.
Wow.
And she's kind of trying to figure out how to manage this new kind of family dynamic. And so it's through her and her father's connection to welding, he starts to teach her how to weld, that she finds her voice and is able to find, you know, what will this project look like, the one that she's researching for her social studies class. So just a really well-crafted, beautiful new book. So that's Each Tiny Spark by Pablo Cartaya.
And I always want to read every book that Jessica talks about but don't have enough time. So we're going to pair that today with I Can Write the World by Hoshanda Sanders. And this is a book, so Hoshanda is a journalist. So this is a book about a young girl who sees her world. She lives in the Bronx. So she sees it from the view of the outside looking in, other journalists looking at her world, and then from her view inside looking out. So she decides to use her view to tell the world about the Bronx. I learned about this book from Karen Biggs Tucker, our mutual friend, and I have to read a few quotes from it. When she's expressing to her mother, she noticed some graffiti and that a child was being arrested for painting a wall, and the mom was explaining about creativity, and her mom tells her this: creativity is using what you have to make a map of your dreams. And just beautiful quote. And then the other one, when they're talking about journalism, journalists are like a window frame. They tell stories they think we should know. And so it's written as a narrative poem. It's just a beautiful story about using your voice to share that with the world. And of course, you can pair that with Say Something by Peter Reynolds, which also is a book about using your voice. And so citizenship is about sharing your story and using your voice. So we're two traveling teachers, and we'll see you next time.